Welcome to the Hoopsville National Invitational Classic, and these are our special Hoopsville interviews throughout the weekend. I'm Dave McHugh, and I'm now joined by Middlebury head coach Jeff Brown, and we are talking to Coach before he's played any games, so no results will be in this interview if you are wondering and catching this after the weekend. And first and foremost, Coach, welcome to Baltimore. I know this isn't your first trip south into the Mid-Atlantic region, but certainly happy to have you here.
Well, thank you, Dave. We're really pleased to be here and participating in the tournament. It's just an unbelievable opportunity.
Well, you guys have already played three games. Apparently, you guys loaded right on up on that schedule to get going early. Benefit, or are you worried the team may be a little tired?
No, it's certainly a benefit because this is a new team for us. We have new core guys that needed to, you know, be challenged a little bit, and I really feel like you know, we're in a position where we can just build on the experience of being 3-0 at this point in the season.
A team that went to the Elite Eight last year, just missed getting to the Final Four, lost a few key players from that, but you also return a few key players. Let's talk about the makeup of this squad.
Well, again, you know, it begins with Joey Kiesel, our point guard, our team leader and captain. He's had an unbelievable career, went over 1,000 points for his career last season, and he's our team leader. He's the engine. Along with him, Jack Roberts was a starter, a 6'8 senior from Pennsylvania, and a good defender and a rebounder. And the third major player from last year's team, James Jensen, is currently injured and has not been cleared to practice yet. So, you know, we're a little bit undermanned with the injury factor, but again, we have some new blood.
How important is this start to the season, and more importantly, the teams you'll face here and the challenges you'll face as you get ready for conference play in the NESCAC and other New England teams?
Well, that's a big part of us scheduling coming down here, is to really put a challenge to our guys and to really step up the level of competition, because the NESCAC is one of the top leagues in the country, and, you know, playing Stevenson on Friday night and playing St. Mary's on Sunday is going to give us a real test of what NESCAC basketball is all about.
Speaking of the NESCAC, Amherst, of course, wins another national championship for them, and, you know, Williams has won titles. You guys have been right on the cusp of kind of taking that next step yourselves. How do you see it happening this year? Do you see it happening down the road? Do you feel like it's necessary to kind of keep up with the Joneses, as it were?
Well, it's certainly not necessary. Each year takes its own shape. I had the opportunity to watch Amherst cut down the nets last March in April in Atlanta.
Right.
And, you know, it was really thrilling to see a NESCAC team celebrate on that floor in that type of venue and so forth. And it just shows how great Division III basketball is in the country. And whenever, you know, in the NESCAC we can have one, two, or three teams mentioned nationally, I think it really speaks volumes for our league.
Let's talk about the league a little bit. Obviously, there's Amherst and there's Williams and there's yourselves, but there's always another one or two teams that come out every year that kind of surprise people. There's talk about Wesleyan maybe this year. There's talk about Tufts. You know, Trinity, Connecticut's always been in the conversation. You got others in there as well. But who do you have your eye on if it's not the top three?
Well, so, you know, to me it's Tufts because they were very close last year and played a grueling schedule. They returned some great parts. They have a terrific freshman group coming in this season. So it would not surprise me if they end up at the top of our league. That being said, you know, in our last four league games last year, we won three of them by a combined total of 6 points.
Yeah.
And it really just speaks that there's a lot of balance, you know, within the league, despite the overall records.
Of course, outside the league, the New England region has really stepped up in other teams. WPI, Rhode Island College, you know, Western and Eastern Connecticut have been in the conversation. There's more and more teams, it seems, in the Northeast that are rising to the top to kind of meet the NESCAC challenge. How great is that? And at the same time, how much of it is a little bit of a challenge for you guys now?
Well, you know, it's certainly great for the region. You know, we're the biggest region in terms of number of schools, so I think that speaks to why we have maybe a group that might be associated in the top 20 in the country. You know, we're a little bit spread out, so sometimes it's challenging in terms of developing the schedule to play some additional top-notch, you know, non-league opponents in region. But, you know, that's why we're here trying to go outside the region to play high-level competition. And, again, just really excited to be here and be a part of the tournament.
I was going to say, first time down here for the Hoopsville Classic. Granted, in its second year, you would have had to have been a repeat to do it otherwise. What are you expecting from here? How's the trip? How was the trip down? All that?
The trip is great. We had an eight-hour trip after the class day yesterday, so we didn't get into the hotel till about 1:15. The accommodations are terrific. We had an opportunity to stretch our legs and get a shoot this afternoon. And just walking into this building about 30 minutes ago, it's really a great venue, a great facility, and everything is very first class, and we're just looking forward to the competition.
Obviously, we don't know what their results are. They have Stevenson. When we're talking Stevenson, and of course, St. Mary's on Sunday. When you looked at the matchups and you saw whether it was Stevenson, because you know it's the home team, or you saw it was St. Mary's, a ranked team that certainly has a lot of success. You guys have seen them before. What was the thinking when you saw that?
Well, excited. I feel like St. Mary's and Middlebury are sort of tied together because we were able to defeat them to go to a Final Four in Rochester. And then being with them in the Final Eight last year, the Cabrini team that is in the tournament this year won the sectional at our place 2 years ago. And, you know, with Stevenson, there is a Vermont connection that the athletic director, Brett Adams, is from Vermont. And I've known Brett for a long time, and I'm really thankful that he's allowed us to be a part of this.
Well, my other question to you, of course, is obviously you know all the teams. What's the expectation? Do you want to come out of your 2-0? Do you mind coming out 1-1? I assume you want to avoid 0-2.
That's pretty accurate, but we we want to win both.
Yeah.
I will not lie about that. But again, we haven't put any great expectations on our group this year, just being so young, graduating 3,000 career points from last year's team. You know, it's an entirely different feel. But I believe our guys are confident and will be energetic in the two games. And, we hope to at least challenge to win two.
Now, we appreciate you coming down for the tournament and looking forward to seeing you play. As always, I give the guests the final word. Any thoughts you want to share with those who may be watching this?
Well, just again that, what D3 Hoops does for college basketball in the Division III level is special. And, along with the competition factor of coming down here to play two great opponents, it's an experience for our student athletes that they'll remember the rest of their lives. And again, that's a big reason that why Middlebury is here, is just so our guys can experience being treated in a great fashion and sort of play in the spotlight.
Well, thank you for coming down. We certainly appreciate it and look forward to seeing you play.
Thank you, Dave.
Jeff Brown from Middlebury. We'll see his team play, and we'll have much more interviews throughout the weekend. So make sure you tune in to us here and follow the tournament on hashtag HVilleClassic on Twitter. We'll be back with more down throughout the weekend.